Hello, good morning or good evening, wherever you are. My name is Shua Khan. We're going to talk about K-self-test running in test rings and where the status, where we are, and so on. I've given this talk at LPC as well. We had a good discussion there about that. And then I'll also go over what we have done, the recent release that came up, and what feature that went into that feature. So quickly, what are we going to talk about today? We're going to talk about general overview of K-self-test, and then K-self-test goals and some of the challenges that we encounter in supporting K-self-test across all of kernel subsystems and use cases. And then we'll also talk about running K-self-test in test rings. And we'll talk about what is involved in supporting kernel CI as well, and then some of the next steps we'll identify. So what is K-self-test? K-self-test, kernel self-test is a kernel subsystem that contains developer test suites for various kernel subsystems, spanning from memory management, architecture, tests, and so on. It is a kernel developer test suite, and it is a and then users, it's a developer test suite for developers as well as users, kernel users. So what is it? It is a collection of tests, open and closed box tests. So when I say open, it is since the developers write their own tests, they know the code and they end up writing tests to test their own code. In that respect, it is an open test suite. And a closed box test suite, meaning we do have a collection of user tests that run, so they become tests written by people that don't know the code as much. So that in itself, it's a closed box test. We have both of those in there. And then we have some functional tests that test the functionality of system calls and so on, or driver functionality in some cases, some drivers. And then it's also a feature-specific tests. And then we have a mix of hardware and drivers tests, and we also have a few stress and performance in there. Where you can find all of these tests, it's maintained in a Linux K-self-test Git on the kernel.org, and there is a Patchwork project as well. If you look on the Patchwork, you will see kernel self-test there. And you can also reach me, and you can reach the developers that act and that and users that use self-test on test strings on Freenode, Linux K-self-test channel. So what is the focus of this testing? The primary focus is testing features, functionality, and regression tests, and also subsystem focused. So when a new API gets added to, say, memory management subsystem, or the SecCom, for example, any new system calls get added, the tests get added to specifically to regression tests in the first place, and then also verify the new functionality. So what is it not for? Let's talk about, I so far talked about what it is for, and now we'll talk about what it's not for. It is not for testing a specific workload or specific application. So who are the authors of these, who writes these tests? Kernel developers and kernel users write these tests. And who are the users? Kernel developers as well as kernel users. That is, test strings, for example. So there is a overlap between developers and users, right? Because it spans multiple subsystems. For example, somebody that is not actively working on the networking subsystem, for example, they might use it to test routinely if they are testing, if they are running some tests, they want to make sure networking is okay. They might use the networking tests as users. So there is an overlap between developers and users. So let's talk a little bit about patch flow. If you are contributing to kernel self-tests or you are just using them, it would be good to know how the patches flow. It is a little bit different from rest of the subsystems. In some ways, it is similar to documentation, how documentation patches are handled. Kernel, because of the dependency on tests that have on the kernel API, the patch flow is tuned to that specific situation. So if, for example, a new API gets added or new change gets made in a particular subsystem, MM or networking or x86 or any subsystem, and then the developers send a patch series, they will send a patch series tests with the changes that are being made to that subsystem. As a result, there are going to be dependencies between the new code that's getting added to that particular subsystem Git and kself tests. The self test new tests are changes to the tests in that area. So as a result, they're all will be combined and will go through that subsystem tree. Not all tests go through Linux kself test tree. So you will see that happening during the merge window. You will see that a lot of tests go through different subsystems. They get added to different subsystems. And the way we manage it is we run, we integrate them in Linux Next. We catch any problems for the most part to try to catch the problems in test breakages during that time, or we'll catch it in after RC1 comes out. So just know that that's how the patch flow works. So let's take a look at the individual, what does a test look like? I mean, what do we mean by a test? So the test directory is, if you go into tools, into the kernel Git, and you'll go to tools, testing, self-tests directory, under that directory, you'll see multiple subdirectories. Each subdirectory covers a specific subsystem. You will see in that, you will see timers, for example. All of the timers tests will be under that. And then you will see VM, and then under that, you'll see VM tests. And there will be each specific area subsystem, you will see tests underneath. And then each directory, under each of those subsystems, you will find multiple tests for the most part. If it's a substantial, the subsystem has large number of tests, you will see several tests, and each test will have individual test cases sometimes. And then it is a subtest and an individual test case. So when you run a test for a subsystem or a specific test, you might be exercising several test cases. So we talked, now that's kind of covers the overview and how patches flow and what is the test looks like, what do we mean by a test, and then test individual test cases. Now let's talk about the challenges and goals, and goals and challenges in that order. The goal has always been evolving a common framework flexible to customizing tests, because the goal is to spend more time writing tests and not worry about common framework. We do end up spending time in fixing framework problems, but the ratio of new tests versus the effort spent in framework is in that order, we want to spend more time writing tests. The idea is increasing coverage for drivers and the various configurations in the kernel and also features. We have regression tests for fixed bugs as we find bugs and we fix them. We end up adding tests to regression tests, add regression tests for those specifically so that we don't miss that next time around. And what does some of the, these are all the challenges and then the goals at the same time. We have common interfaces for pass fail, skip reporting. So when we write new tests, we want to make sure those new tests fit into that framework. And we are also support, being able to run individual tests, meaning not the entire test suite, but being able to select and run a particular subsystem or a particular test. So we'll get into that a little more later on. And then also reporting. Reporting is a common framework thing. We support reporting results in using TAP, Test Anything Protocol. We're currently, I think, 13, and we are we keep updating it to be compliant as the protocol moves. And another goal we have is balancing kernel self-test runtime and coverage. Right now, when we started, we were thinking we'll hold the time to a specific, 20 minutes or whatever. We had some goals, but right now we have lots of tests. So right now the goal has changed a little bit that we are tuned more towards coverage than runtime back when we started 4 or 5 years ago. This is quickly talked about a little bit of a challenge that we have is because of the nature of kernel self-test itself, it is primarily for kernel developers to make sure that their subsystems are, they are not introducing regressions when they develop new features and they continue to look for the health of their subsystem. It is tilted towards kernel developer use cases. We do keep adding user use cases, but I have to say that it is more tilted. So we kind of try to balance both, but that is in itself is a little bit of a challenge because of that. The framework tends to, there is a push and pull between the common framework where we are trying to address the needs of kernel developers as well as users. So for example, users would like to just run the entire test suite, whereas kernel developers don't really want to, they want to focus on their own subsystem at times, and they want to quickly run and make sure they haven't regressed anything. So as a result, we are continuously balancing those two use cases where we are trying to support both communities. So framework is so we are evolving the common addressing user cases use cases. We are evolving the common framework to support testing use because that is beneficial to all of us. Because if we can run kernel self tests in test rings, then we catch problems early. We'll get into the test rings a little bit later, but Linux Next, Linaro Test Ring LKFT, they run Linux Next on KSelf tests on, they run on the Linux Next branch, and we do find a problems, test breakages early on because of that. So the framework, to touch on the framework is, like I said, framework is well suited for manual testing. Manual testing essentially is kernel developer testing. And then we are continuously working to make it better to support auto test environments like TestStrings, at the same time not sacrificing the manual ease of manual testing. So let's see KSelf test use cases. Several use cases, native and cross-build use cases. If you look at the kinds of things it can support, somebody should be able to just say, for example, a kernel developer built a new kernel, they booted a new kernel, they just want to test a particular individual test. They might have touched that area. They want to go make sure that that didn't break. So they should be able to run that individual test. And they might be able to, in some cases, they might have spanned multiple, maybe they made changes to an area of the kernel that could affect a couple of subsystems. They want to be able to isolate those subsystems and say, let's run tests, only those tests. And they should also be able to just run all of them, all of the tests that exists under the self-test directory. Relocating, the other use case is being able to relocate native and cross-build objects. So one use case is your development and test system is the same. You are running your test kernel on your development system. There is no relocation involved. You're just rebooted your system with the new kernel and you are running tests. The other case is, you actually build tests and you might build tests for, you are natively working on x86-64, for example, and you are building tests for another x86-64 system. That is kind of native build, but you are relocating the build to be able to copy the objects to your target system. And in another case is, you are working on a x86 system, development system, but you're cross-building your tests and kernel and so on for a ARM64, for example. In that case, you're cross-building and you want to relocate the objects and then copy them over to your target system. So generating, there are two use cases, runtime use cases where you are generating. So what KSelfTest does is when you are running it in install mode, when you're running KSelfTest and using make KSelfTest, it'll just run it on your system. But when you are installing, it will go generate a run script, because in some of the tests need to have modules loaded, certain kernel modules loaded to be able to actually run the test. So to give again an example, the kernels, the self tests, they are executables that just run. In some cases, they are shell scripts that call other executables, and they in some cases they also load kernel modules and unload them afterwards. So let's see. Let me find myself here. I think I am a bit lost. Okay. So we covered this part. And then a kernel, KSelfTest and test strings. So I quickly talked about Linux Next being run on, how does it run? Linux kernel functional testing, LKFT ring. It runs various releases, like for example, stable release, and then Linux mainline, and then active kernel, all of the active kernel releases essentially. So there is Linux Next in all of the cases, other than one exception, KSelfTest is rev matched with you take the stable releases same in general kernels. So there is a tie between kernel self-test and then the kernel release itself because of the nature of the testing it's done. K-self tests from the same repo are used to rev match the kernel. One exception is latest stable is run on all the stable release for this particular testing. And then in general, you want to rev match the kernel because you might have header changes in the kernel that the tests might depend on. So 0-day runs kernel self-tests from mainline on several trees and kernel configurations. Kernel CI use cases. So we have been working on, this is one thing that we have been working on. I think we are at the moment, we are able to build them and then we are able to run some tests in kernel CI, but this has been a work in progress. And now, as of 5.6 kernel, which is a few releases ago, we're able to build support native and cross builds, all of the tests except BPF. BPF has special requirements. As a result, it is difficult for it to build in a, it is rev matched with the kernel. So it is difficult for it to build. So we kind of not worry about that at the moment. We are working on that, but we treat BPF as a special case because of the dependencies it has on the runtime environment. Let's see, kernel, we added a new kernel dependencies shell script, which will evaluate your development system to see if you have all of the packages installed for it to be able to do cross builds. That's and cross builds, because when you are cross building, kernel self-test will depend on certain libraries. In some cases you have mount, live mount, you some tests depend on special libraries, so you want to make sure that all of your development system is set up correctly to be able to do cross builds. So that's this shell script will go through and evaluate your development system and make sure you have all of the dependencies met. And it'll also tell you which tests can be built with the current packages you have installed on there and what you need to install to build more. So use cases are similar in the sense that you want to be able to build and cross build tests for specific configurations. So we do have a way to pull in with specify dependencies for tests. For example, some tests will depend on a certain kernel configuration to be enabled in the kernel itself. And then it'll do, if you do not have those, kernel make kself test merge generates a kernel config to include individual test configuration files. So you can run that and then it will make sure that your kernel that you're building will have the right configurations enabled for you to be able to test, run the tests that you want to run on that kernel. And then I'll quickly go over kselftest commands. And you can, say you are planning to build, and it is the commands are tuned for three different cases. Whereas you can just build all of them, or you can build and run. The second if you were to run make kself test on the kernel directory, main root directory, what it will do is it'll build all the tests and then and build tests that it can build. You might see some failures, build failures, but it'll go on. It won't stop. It'll just build and then run them, run all the tests it built on the same system. Make KSL test all will just build them. It will not run it. Make KSL test install will actually build and run, as well as it will generate a run script that you can use to, which is what is run. When you run that script, you will run all of the tests. So if you were to do, you can isolate targets. Targets is a variable, make a variable that you can pass it to. KSelf test all of them, KSelf test install all of the above commands, the three commands, and then you can isolate specific tests that way. You can say, I only want to run breakpoints or timers or any other, you can give a multiple tests that you want to isolate and run. So what it'll do is it'll generate run script for just the tests, either the tests, if you isolated tests, it'll generate it for those targets. Otherwise, if you don't have targets, then it'll build and generate for all of the tests under the self-test directory that are enabled, specified in the makefile. Self-test makefile is the one that controls the targets variable. So whenever a new test get added, the new directory usually or gets added, it will be added to the KSelfTest makefile as well. So Cardinal CI workflow, because of the relocatable, for example, you would have to build the kernel first, and then I'm showing a def config, but you know, it depends on what, if you have a specific configuration, you can use that. And then you will build the kernel, and then you will then build the build KSelf test. So if you were to do a KSelf test all, you can relocate your objects and then into a build directory. And then from there, you can take that and then you can install that onto a target machine, and then you'll be able to run. You'll have a run KSelf test, run underscore KSelf test dot sh generated in the directory for you. So this is another way for you to do cross compile and relocate. You can O equal to the build directory, you can specify that, and then you are specifying the cross compiler here, and then you're doing the install. You're actually installing. Install really means what it does is it'll create the under your build directory, it will generate all the objects you need, including the run script that you can copy over to the target system to run your tests. So before 5.10, run KSelf test script, you pretty much had to run everything you built. If you didn't isolate the tests at the time, targets, then you ended up with all the tests. So there is a new ability that we added, feature we added, that we can now go isolate the tests after building. Run, you will have all the executables. All of the install is done. And you can go run specific tests you want from the run KSelf test script, the script that runs the whole thing. You can say, I only want certain tests I want to run. And in addition to that, it can even isolate individual tests. Like for example, you can see here that it can isolate from the timers test suite, it can isolate one single test, NanoSleep, for example. So this is a new feature that went into Linux 5.10, and it's in RC1 now. And want to leave time for questions as well. So next steps, we are continuously working on these next steps. These next steps is being able to add support for specific configs, and then support for specific features, which is a bit tricky because of the single test could cover multiple features. So that's a bit tricky, but we're continuously working on that. We're trying to get to a point where we can run. It is a very active subsystem because so originally when we started out, we started adding tests for features that existed in the kernel. And then now we are in the mode where we are adding tests as we add kernel features, new features. And we also go make changes to these tests. We are continuously adding tests and changing existing tests. As a result, this is a moving target in some ways, because at times we find a new test might require a change to the framework sometimes, or we find the framework, a particular test doesn't build because of the number of use cases we support. In some cases, a test comes in and then that test might break a particular use case, or it doesn't work with the particular use case. So we end up fixing problems. So it's kind of a moving target in some ways. We, especially being able to support in the test strings. So because of this nature of the flux and change, the test framework, if a new change to a test breaks the use case, then at times it becomes tricky to until that gets fixed. Obviously, test strings we'll have to. So we are fine. But on the good side, we find all of these problems early on. Usually we try to find them in the Linux Next, and we are focusing on finding them and fixing them before RC1 comes out. And if some breakages happen, we are trying to catch them early on during the release cycle. So that is it for my presentation. I'll open this up for questions. You can post questions in the chat channel. Okay, I have a question from, okay. So does that answer your question, Tim, I guess? So this, there is a question, dash L flag emits a list of tests which should be parsable for a framework to loop over or filter. I'll have to look into that. I have to play with that test and that feature a little bit more before I can answer that question. I raised my volume guy a little bit, so I hope this is working better. I didn't realize that volume is low. So, okay, let me see. I'm looking at the questions here. I have a question. Okay, are there any other questions? Can you hear me better now? So there is a question here, are there any famous bugs during case of test packaging for Linux stable and beyond to run in other platforms and K-self-test in general? Is there a place where I can find this kind of information? So yes and no, we don't, it's the bugs are reported on mailing lists like any other subsystem bugs for K-self-test as well. And then we don't have it is reported on the mailing list. That's all I can say. Yeah, we don't have a place, the Bugzilla type place that we have. We track these bugs. All right, let me see if I have any more questions. Any other questions? Thanks, everybody. There are no questions. I'm not seeing any questions in the chat.